chain 57, this part of the square needs a multiple of 5. So if you adjusting the stitch, as I stated with the first square, you will need to make sure that it's uniform with all the squares. Square 1, square 2, square 3. Make sure that you have similar weight, dimension. As I stated, I'm working with 9 inches. So, we'll chain 57. So I have 57 chains here. I'll work in half double crochet into the third chain from hook 1, 2, 3 and into each of the stitches, into each of the chains. So if you used to working your foundation chain, you can as well do that. Foundation half double crochet, that's okay. So I work this into each of the chains. The essence of having half double crochet in each of the stitches in both of the squares, referring to the second square and this square, is to be able to have a smooth joining when we join all our squares together. That will be the next video that will be up, showing the easy way to put this together. And thank you all for everyone that has participated thus far, showing different colors, the progress thus far, their squares. Seriously, I can't wait to see how this will all end up, and your beautiful blankets in different sizes that you've all decided to make. I'm encouraged to make more tutorials for you. Thank you so much. And please kindly subscribe to my channel to get notified of my subsequent tutorials. If you have any questions on the stitches or the way any of the rows have been worked, you can drop them in the comment section. I'll be sure to reply and respond as soon as I get them. So, half double crochet in each of the stitches to the end of the row. I look like I crochet half double crochet so slowly. So this will give us 55 half double crochet. So if you adjusting, you might need to chain, if you want to go a little smaller on your hook or on your squares, or if you're unable to meet gauge, you might want to crochet 52 stitches, start with 52 chains to end up with 50 half double crochet, or go up to 62 to end up with 60 half double crochet. Whatever adjustment you make, it must be your stitch count after the round, the first row should be multiple of 5. So that will mean your foundation chain should be multiple of 5 plus 2. So row 2, chain 1 and turn. Single crochet in the first 2 stitches, chain 2, skip next 2 stitches, you work single crochet in the next 3 stitches, and then we'll repeat from chain 2, skip next 2 stitches, chain 3, as single crochet in the next 3 stitches. We'll repeat that sequence till the end of the row to our last 4 stitches. Single crochet in next 3 stitches, chain 2, skip next 2 stitches, single crochet in next 3 stitches, see that, chain 2, let me focus it a little more, Great. Skip next 2 stitches, single crochet in next 3 stitches, chain 2, skip next 2 stitches, single crochet in next 3 stitches, skip 2, stitches, and then so that's the sequence that will repeat till our last 4 stitches. So we'll repeat that till the end, the last 4 stitches. We're at the end of the row, we have 4 more stitches to go. So we'll chain 2, skip next 2 stitches, and we'll work in double crochet as single crochet in last 2 stitches. This gives us 11 chain ones, chain 2 spaces, and 34 single crochet. So row 3, we've done, we'll chain 1, 2, 3. Now we'll come back to our beloved shell. That's 5 double crochet in each of the chain 2 spaces. You see that? Into the chain 2 spaces. So we really don't need the single crochet stitches again. We'll repeat this in each of the chain 2 spaces till the end of the row. Shell in each of the chain 2 spaces. So, 5 double crochet in each of the chain 2 spaces till the end of the row. We'll give off, since we have 11 chain 2 spaces, that means we'll have 11 shells, which will be 55 double crochet. But to make it easier on us, we'll just go by the shells. 5 double crochets in each of the chain 2 spaces. You skip the single crochet stitches and go into the next. This is what it looks like. To the next chain space and work in 5 double crochet. So we are at the last chain 1 space, chain 2 space. We'll be working in our last shell, which we've done, and then we'll work a double crochet in the first stitch. This is to have make sure that our edges comes out smooth. See that? So this is what it looks like when we turn. That's the wrong side, and this is what it looks like on the right side. See that? So this is what we just finished. We'll be going to the next round, next row, which is chain 4. And our chain 4 counts as a double crochet plus chain 1. when we're working the next round row, we'll be referring to the fourth chain as our chain one. So we'll double crochet in next stitch. Since this counts as a stitch, we will not be working into this. Clear? We're counting our beginning chain four as a stitch. That means we'll not be working into this. It's our first stitch. So we'll be working into the first double crochet in the shell. Double crochet in that stitch, which makes this double crochet and chain one. Chain one, skip next three stitches, one, two, three. Work in a double crochet into the next stitch. That's the last double crochet of the shell. Chain two, double crochet into the next stitch. So, bingo, that's what we have to work with. Chain one, and we'll repeat. Skip next three stitches, one, two, three, and work in a double crochet into the next stitch. Chain two, double crochet into the next stitch. See that? Chain one, skip next three stitches, double crochet into the next stitch. Chain two, double crochet into the next stitch. That is what our work looks like now. Chain one, skip next three stitches, double crochet into the next. Skip chain two, double crochet into the next stitch. Chain one, skip next three stitches. Good. We'll repeat this till the end of the row. So we'll at the end of the row, and then we'll be chaining two, double crochet in next stitch, chain one, skip the next three stitches, double crochet in the next stitch. So chain one space, beginning chain from the previous round will be what we walk into at the end of the row. So we ended up with a double crochet, chain one, double crochet. That is what it looks like at the end of this round. We have 24 double crochet and 23 chain spaces. You turn your work, and then we'll chain three, two double crochet in this chain one space, which makes it three double crochet. We're counting our beginning chain as a stitch with this square. So we don't have anything to do with this chain space. We're moving into each of the chain spaces that looks like a V stitch. If you look closely, you see that this looks like a V stitch, a V stitch, a V stitch. That's because we have two chains. Chain two, chain two, chain two. So we'll be skipping each of the chain one spaces and work shell into each of the chain two spaces. We'll continue this sequence to the end. Skip this chain one space and work in five double crochet, that's shell, in next chain space. Skip next stitch, work five double crochet in the next stitch. And then we'll repeat the sequence. Five double crochet in each of the chain two spaces. This is what it will look like. At the end of the row. So, till the end of the last chain two space, we add a double crochet, five double crochet in the last chain space, chain two space, and then work in two, three double crochet in the last chain one space. So we'll go ahead to the next row. Chain four, turn, and then we'll skip the next stitch. I told you we're counting our beginning chain as a stitch. So this is the first stitch. We have a chain space. Skip the next stitch and then work in a double crochet into this. Chain two, double crochet into the next stitch. Chain one, skip next three stitches, double crochet into the next. Chain two, double crochet in the next. Chain one, skip next three stitches, double crochet into the next stitch. Chain one, chain two, double crochet into the next stitch, and then we'll repeat till the end of the row. So, to the end of the row, we've done repeated that sequence till we add three double crochet at the end. So, chain one, and then we skip next stitch and work in a double crochet into the next. So, that is what it looks like. We'll go ahead now to repeat row 3 to 6, which is the basics for the pattern. So the aim is to have a shell, three double crochet. Now we'll start with having a shell in the next stitch. So now row 3 will be shell in each chain two spaces. And then we'll repeat this till row 39 to continue. We'll repeat row 3, row 4, and 5 and 6 till the end of this square, which is row 39. So, 5 double crochet in each of the stitches. This is row 3 that I'm repeating. I'll come back after this row 4, row 5, row 6, go back to row 3, and we'll continue in that sequence till we're at row 39. I'll be back to show you what mine looks like at row 39. So, here is what it looks like at row 27, 25. So, we'll continue to repeat the sequence, and we have three double crochets at the end of this row, which means we have three double crochet at the beginning of the row, and that makes it that the next row that I'll be repeating now is what row? Can you guess? I'll be repeating what row? Row 6. So we'll turn and we'll chain, sorry, we'll chain 4. We'll skip the next stitch and we'll work in a double crochet in the next. Chain 2, a double crochet in the next stitch. Chain 1, skip next 3 stitches and we'll work in a double crochet in the next stitch. Chain 2, double crochet in the next. Chain one, skip next 3 stitches, work in a double crochet in the next. Chain two, and you work in double crochet in the next. This is the sequence that we'll be repeating. Okay. I'm sure that by now most of you are already used to the repeats, the sequence, and if you're not, or you're probably getting confused by the break after a few more rows, there's a link in the description where you'll see the free written pattern which you can easily follow for the repeats. And then the video is just showing how it is done. I seriously need to love to see what you come up with, the different colors that you're using. There's a link to show what color you've used in the description box. Come show us in the group. Come see what other people are using, what colors others are using. Great, so we're done with row 28, which is a repeat of row 6. Now we'll be going to the next row, which is row 29, and that's repeat row 3. Remember, chain in each of the chain 2 spaces. So to keep up with the number of rows that you're working on and not to get confused, the major difference is just between row 3 and row 6. Make sure that once you see that you have 3 double crochet here, you know that the next shell you're working will start with 5. You see, 5 double crochet is the first shell, 3 double crochet, 5. If we continue this sequence, the next will be 3 double crochet, the next shell part will be 5 double crochet. I'm not sure if what I've explained makes it any easier, but it's really helpful so that I don't really need to keep track of what row I am working on. So, shelling each of the chain 2 spaces makes it super easy to follow. See that? And then you will measure and see how far we've gone after this row. So I'll continue chain 2 in each of the, I'll continue shell 5 double crochet in each of the chain 2 spaces. This is what we have at the end of the row. So you need to make sure, as I've stated, that it's of importance that you have similar lengths so as to have a fitted beautiful squares together. So this is what the second square looks like. See that? This is what it looks like. So you want to make sure that you have similar size, and then this is what the first looks like. So they should be of similar size or similar sizes to have a perfect pattern. So now the next, we're increasing the squares. We've made the first, we're making the second, third, fourth squares. So we want to add 3 more. So this is the first made. We making this curve. Now we'll have some chains and then we'll continue. Okay, let me remove the camera and make a, sorry. So this is the first square that has been made. Instead of having a lot of sewing done, we want to cuff it. Let me raise it up. This is where we're going. I've made the first, I'm making the second now. So this is what we, this is the part that we want to start now. Yeah, so this is the first square. We're making second, third, and fourth square. So let's go ahead. So now at the end of either the first set, you should either end with a row 4 or a row 6. So now you need to, without turning, we want to make the next set of squares. We'll chain 56. So I've chained 56 and this is my 56 chains. Can you see that? So now we can begin to work on the chains that we made. We'll work single crochet in second, in first 2 chains. So 1, 2, right? And then we chain 2, skip next 2 chains, and then you work in single crochet in next 3 chains. I'm sure this part looks familiar. Chain 2, skip next 2 chains, single crochet in the next three chains. Chain two, skip next two chains, and then work in single crochet in the next three chains. So we'll repeat this sequence till last four chains. Single crochet in next three chains. Chain two, skip next two chains. So I'll continue and I'll be back when I have four more chains to work into. So I'm at the last end of the row and I have four more chains to go. So we'll just end it, we finished with chain three and single crochet in next three stitches. So now with four more stitches to go, four more chains to go, you chain two, skip next two chains and single crochet in last two chains. See that? So this is what it looks like. So we'll pick up the first square that we made. See that? Where this is what we've done. We've made the we continue a step ladder sort of. That's how the pattern is worked. So we pick up the main part of the square, and then we single crochet in four stitch. That makes three single crochet. You know, we single crochet in the last two chains, single crochet in first now. Then you double crochet in next stitch, chain one, skip next three stitches, double crochet in the next stitch, chain two, double crochet in the next stitch, chain one, skip next three stitches, chain two, double crochet in the next, chain one, skip next three stitches, and then you work in a double crochet in the next stitch, chain two, and we'll continue that sequence till we're at the end of the row. So, chain two, double crochet, and then we are at the end of the row. We'll chain one and then we'll work in a double crochet in last stitch. Great. So, we are not going to turn, because we need to make the next set of squares. The last square, we added three more squares. We made, this is the first base for the first square, the chain at the beginning. This will serve as second square, third square will be here, and then the fourth square will be here. So to do that, now, instead of turning and working on what we've done, we'll chain 56 again. So I have 56 that I've chained. See, this is what it looks like after chaining 56. And you can see this is where we started the row from. So the next thing now is to repeat what we did with the initial 56 we had at the beginning. We'll start by working in single crochet in the second chain from hook. See that? And in the next stitch, we'll chain two and skip the next two chains, single crochet in the next three chains, chain two, skip next two stitches, next two chains, and then you work in single crochet in the next three stitches. That's the next three chains. We'll repeat the sequence till the last four chains. So it's basically a repeat of what we did with the first two, the first parts of our 56 chains. See? Chain two, one, two, skip next two chains and double crochet in the next three chains. Chain two, skip next two, and then work in double crochet in the next three chains. We'll work in this sequence till the last four chains. So one, two, and then we'll work in double, oh, sorry, single crochet in the next three chains. One, two, and we'll pick it into the next two chains, three chains. So for the number of squares, if you're making a baby sized blanket or you're working on a throw, you can always stop after this set of squares. But if you want to make more, you continue the squares that you, like after the next three, when you're done, we have another 9 inches. You can still may add more squares. So now we are at the last four chains. We'll chain two and we'll skip the next two chains, single crochet in the last two chains. See that? So this is what it looks like. So I will slip stitch into the first chain on the body of the, see that? Let me make it a bit more clearer. So I've had my single crochet in the last two chains. I'll st slip stitch into the first stitch on the main square, and then I'll cast my yarn and fasten off. So that is it. Great. So you fasten off, and this is what it looks like. We have this, and then we have this too. This is what we have at the present. You see that? So to continue the pattern, this is with the right side facing you. This is the right side of the work. We'll join in our yarn with a slip stitch to the beginning. Make sure that you don't have a twist to the beginning of the row. Yeah, then I pick my yarn. I join with a slip stitch. Great. So this is now what we're starting row two, chain three, and we work in a shell in each of our chain two spaces. So throughout the row, we no longer have just only one shell, one square. We now have three squares. Those are the essence of the chain 56 that we made. So if you want more shells, after the three shells, after the three squares, you chain 56 again, chain 56, and then repeat what we did by picking the second, third, fourth square, chain 56, and that will give you more length as to you can repeat that till you have your desired length width for your blanket. Well, make sure that you replicate that with the number of squares that you make in part one, and also with the number of squares in part two. Great. So we work in 5 double crochet in each of the chain two spaces, and then we can continue from there. So we have more things to work on now. I'll continue working in each of the chain two spaces, 5 double crochet in each of the chain two spaces. So we're still working on the first square. So at the end of each of the once you have 56 chains, you should still measure to make sure that you have similar measurement of for your squares. The first square measures 9 inches by 9 inches. That's 9 inches square. So meaning that with adding three more squares, we should have 9 inches in three places. That will give us 27 square. So we'll, instead at this pace, you won't need to repeat to 27 square. It will be 27 by 9. I hope you understand what I just said. This square, this part from here to here, will measure 9 inches. From this part to this part, will measure 9 inches, and from this part to here should measure another 9 inches, so which will give us 27 inches. So you repeat the sequence of your shell chain space till you have 9 inches. So that will be from here to the end, 27 inches through or by 9 inches. So yeah, we're done with the first part of the square. Five double crochet in each of the chain two spaces. We're picking up the next. So we'll work in 5 double crochet in the next chain space. This will have been a chain 3 double crochet space, but to work in uniformity of the pattern, there won't be 3 double crochet in the middle of the pattern. So we'll have shell in each of the chain spaces. See that? So we're working into the middle part of the square now. That's the number 3. 1, 2, 3. Yeah, so this is what it looks like. You can see the smooth transition. This has saved us the stress of joining the squares together. But if it's a little challenging for you to make this taper part, you can just make this. When you're done, set it aside, make 3 more and join together. I was just looking for means of making it super easy that we don't need to sew many times. So I'll repeat this to the end of the pattern. Shell 5 double crochet in each of the chain two spaces. So we'll skip all chain one spaces. If there's any part that isn't clear, you can please give me a message in the comment section, and I'll be sure to respond as soon as I get those. So we're working on the middle parts of the 3 new squares that we've added. Don't get carried away by working in more double crochet into the squares. Fry come by super easy and faster than you think. So, the last chain one space will work in a 5 double crochet in there. See, this is what it looks like at the end. We pick up the next set of squares, next set of square, that's and into each of the chain spaces. We'll work in 5 double crochet. So that's about all. So I'll repeat this to you, the end of the row, and then I'll be back to explain what to do next. So at the end of the row, we have 5 double crochet. So we skip the last stitch, a next stitch, and work in a double crochet into the last stitch. Bravo. So this makes gives us a total of 34 double crochets and 34 shells and 2 double crochets. So great. So this is what it looks like. We have in our first set of square, next set of squares, and the last set of square. See that? I just can't focus on it. Let me try and see if I can adjust my camera to focus on the length that we have. This is what it looks like. See that? So this is 29 inches, 27 inch long. That's it from here. Yeah, that's. This is what we have now, 27 inch long set of squares. So this will work in as a rectangle. This is how it looks like on the bigger part. We'll continue the repeat now. This is what it looks like after we're done with this part. See that? Can you see the curve from the first one that I did? It goes all the way to this. So that's how it will look. See the curve? Yeah, so back to the work. So now we'll turn and then we'll continue with row 3. We'll chain 4 and then we'll skip the next stitch and work in a double crochet. Next stitch, chain 2. Oh, sorry. So we have double chain 4. We'll work in. Sorry for the confusion. Yeah, so this is what the beginning of the row looks like for us. So we'll chain 4 and we double crochet in the next stitch. Great. We'll chain 1 and skip the next 3 stitches. Chain 2 and double crochet in the next stitch. Chain 1, skip next 3 stitches and work in double crochet in the next. Chain 2, double crochet in the next stitch. So I'm sure if you made the first square, you're familiar with what we're working with presently now. So we'll repeat this sequence till the end of the row. So we're at the end of the row and we have everything worked out. It's so long now that it's challenging to focus on every of the parts. So now we're going to row four, we'll turn, and then we have chain four, and we'll work in, sorry, we have chain three. We work in two double crochet in the first chain one space, see that? And then shell in each of the chain two spaces. So this is what we'll repeat till the end, to the last chain one space where we'll have in three double crochet, and then we'll turn. So double crochet, five double crochets in each of the chain two spaces till the last chain one space, and then you have three double crochet in the last chain one space. Remember, it's only the beginning chain one and last chain one spaces that you work into in this row. Every other chain one spaces we skip. And by that, this is a chain one space we skip and work in shell in each of the five chain two spaces. So we'll repeat this to the end of the row. So this is the end of the row. We have three double crochet at the end, and then that's the end of row five. Row six, we'll chain, turn, then row six, we'll work in chain three, and then we'll have in row six, sorry, so chain four, rather chain four, this is chain four, skip the next stitch, and then we'll work in double crochet in the next stitch, chain two, double crochet in the next stitch, chain one, skip next three stitches, double crochet in the next, and then we chain two, double crochet in the next stitch, chain one, skip next three stitches, and work in a double crochet in the next stitch, chain two, double crochet in the next stitch. So this is the sequence that we already used to. That's what we'll be repeating throughout this round. And we can now repeat our sequence till we have 9 inches long. So after then, if you want yours to be that, if you are okay with what measurement you have, it can be the end. But if you want to increase the width of your blanket, you after 9 inches, you work in 52 chains on either side to add two more squares. And then, if you still want more length, more width to your blanket, you continue that sequence till you have a good length that you are happy with. Remember, whatever length you determine to have, whatever size of blanket you're working on, once you're done, you will need to make one more of this to be on the opposite side. So great, that's what my repeat looks like, and we'll continue till we're done with this. Thank you.
Now the second set of steps, the square added to the third square looks like after completing the rows. You can see the shape that it has. We started here, and then we made chains, and we turned, made another set of chain on the other side, and this is what we have after the first new set of squares we added. So now we want to add the next set of squares.
Okay, if you remember when we added this set of squares, the second length squares, when we did that few minutes ago, remembered that we when we got here to the end, we chained for the next set 56 for the next set of squares. But I want to show you another method that you can use. at the end of the day you have the same ends to sew in. So you can either continue now, chain 56, and then you single crochet in the first two chains and the likes, you continue the pattern, or you do this when you've worked in your last, sorry for that, when you've worked in your last stitch, that's your double crochet in the last chain, in the last stitch, you can fasten off this. So I have my scissors, you can fasten off. So I just break cut yarn. Great, you can fasten off there and rejoin your yarn on the other side. So you can join your yarn here. You see the difference if you're getting used to how we did the second set of square already. There's no problem. At the end of the day, we end up with the same blanket, the same square, the same stitch. So you can join your yarn with a slip stitch to the other side of the blanket, and you chain 50. You chain 56. So I prefer having chain stitches. If you are not like me and you prefer to use the foundation, chainless foundation stitches, you can do foundation single crochet 52. So 1, 2, 3, 4. I have 56 chains right now. What we're going to do next is to work in single crochet in the second chain from hook. We'll chain single crochet in the next stitch. That single crochet in the first two stitches, chain two, and then we skip the next two chains and work in single crochet in the next three stitches. This is practically the same way we worked the previous this is the same way we added the second two squares. Depending on the size you are making, if you're making a queen size, you need to add more squares after this round. If you are making a throw size, after this set of squares, we're not adding any more squares. We'll continue to join in our squares. If you are making a baby blanket size, after the second set of squares, you stop. So if the number of squares that you require to make is confusing, kindly see the written pattern, which is free on my blog, using the link the description below this video. So you repeat this sequence, chain two, skip two chains, work in three single crochet in the next three chains, chain two, skip next two chains, and then you work in single crochet into the next three chains, chain two, skip next two chains. So this is what we repeat till we are done with all our chains. We made 52 chains, and I stated that if you are not conversant with, or you are not happy making chains, you can go ahead with making your own as your stitches as foundation single crochet. It makes it neat. So we do that to the last four chains that we are on. So we pick up the next body, that's the main panel of our work, and then we work in a single crochet in the first stitch. I prefer to work over the the yarn that I left when I joined at the beginning of the round. So we've worked single crochet in the first stitch. and then work in double crochet into the next stitch. I'm still crocheting over the end. Double crochet into the next stitch. We'll chain one. You skip the next three stitches and you work in double crochet into the next. Chain two and double crochet into the next stitch. So you might be familiar again with what we have. We chain one, skip next three stitches, and then we'll do this till the end of the row. This is what the remaining rows looks like, what we've been doing, the stitches we've really been working on the main panel. This is what we'll continue. We'll do that. Now you know we've added three more squares. One square, two square, and three. This is the third one. So we'll repeat this sequence all through those stitches. Chain one, skip next three stitches, double crochet, chain two, double crochet in the next stitch, chain one, skip next three stitches, double crochet, chain two, double crochet in the next stitch, chain one, skip next three stitches, chain two, double crochet in the next stitch, chain one. So I'll do this till the end of the row. I'll chain one, and then I'll show you how it looks when I get to that part, the end of the row, and then we can continue with our next set of chains to make the next, to extend the pattern so that we can successfully have five squares instead of three. So it's in odd number. We started with the first square, we added three more, and now we're adding five more squares to it. So we have 1, 3, 5. If you're making the king size, you have 1, 3, 5 and what, and 7. So it will be in odd numbers. If you want to make yours to be bigger than the queen size, the king size blanket, when you're done with adding, instead of having 1, 3, 5, 7, you can go ahead to have 1, 3, 5, 7, and 9. So you have to add more squares after each. But remember, we can only add two square at a time, one on either side. And as I stated, the main essence of adding the squares this way is to minimize the number of sewing that we need to do. And I kind of find it so beautiful that you don't really need to do things the conventional way. You can as well think out of the box, which was what I did by making the squares in this shape. Looks like the stairs, one leading to the other, and it makes the number of sewing that we need to do once we are done with all the squares, it minimizes it, and it has this beautiful look to it. I'd like to see what color you've been using for square 1, square 2, square 3. Kindly come over to the Facebook group. The link is in the description to see what other people are using, other colors that people are using for their beautiful blankets, and show us what you've done. The end of the row, I skip the next three stitches and I work in a double crochet in the next stitch, chain one, and work in a double crochet in the last stitch. Yeah, so don't get carried away and torn at this point. We are going to continue by chaining, adding chain 56. So 1, 2. So I have my 56 chains now, and then you can chain. So it's basically a repeat of what we did at the beginning of this row. You know, we made worked in single crochet chain spaces, so we'll continue with that. We'll have single crochet in the next second chain. This is the first chain from hook, second chain from hook. You work single crochet in that and in the next stitch. See that? So you can chain two now, and you work in single, skip next two chains, and work single crochet in the next two chains, in the next three chains rather. Chain two, and then skip the next two chains, single crochet, single crochet in the next three chains. This is the same as what we did at the other end, and which is similar to what we did when we had adding three more squares after row one, the first square. So for those that are making king size, as I've stated earlier on, once you are done with the number of rows required to get you similar size measurements with of all your squares, you repeat this step. You chain. Okay, my yarn is finished. I'll add more yarn now and I'll be back. So we pick up, we're at the end of the row. We finished our chain, so we pick up the next squares and we slip stitch into the part that stitch, fasten off and cut yarn. So far so good. We pick up the next row now. Okay, so we join yarn with a slip stitch to the beginning, which this is the right side facing me, a little twisted, not twisted, a little kinked, but don't let it get twisted. So we join yarn with a slip stitch to the beginning of the row, and we chain three. So three. So now we'll be working shell, which is 5 double crochet in each of the chain two spaces. So it's pretty easy, much easier than every other part of the pattern of the blanket. Sorry. So we'll chain, there is no chain. We'll do that, skip the three stitches here, and we'll continue that sequence. Shell, which is 5 double crochet in each of our chain two spaces. So 5 double crochet in each of the chain two spaces. Continue to the end of the chain spaces. We'll pick up the next panel, which is the main body of the squares, and we'll continue as we did with the body. So this row is mainly 5 double crochet in the chain two spaces. The few peculiarities that are in here is why I won't skip, and I'll continue to do it while we work it together till we get to those areas where I would like to show you some peculiarities. Okay, so we are at the end of the first half, the first square. So we'll pick up the next set of squares and we'll work in a shell in this first chain here. I spoke about the peculiarities of the joining. This is one of it. Good. And then we'll continue from here. In each of the chain two spaces, we'll work in 5 double crochets in each of our chain two spaces. So this is what we'll continue. This is what we'll continue till we are done with this set of squares. We have 3 squares here, and we'll continue to work in 5 double crochet in each of the chain two spaces. Remember, we have one more chain one space at the end. I'm talking about this part. So I'll continue working till I get to this chain one space here, and I'll work in a shell and continue with each of my chain two spaces here to work in 5 double crochet. So it's getting wider and bigger. And for the size that I'm making the true size, the end is near. This is the last set of squares that I'm adding. So I'll do this till my next chain one space at the end of this round. And I'll be back to show you how it looks. So don't forget that you're skipping the chain one spaces and working only into the chain two spaces to work in a shell. So the last chain one space at the end, I've worked in 5 double crochet into it. So next thing to be done now is to pick up the next set of chains, the last half of our crochet square, and continue to work in 5 double crochet, that's our share, in each of our chain two spaces. So looks a little bit invisible, but when you pull it, you get to see your chain two space. So you work in 5 double crochet, which is share, in each of the chain two spaces. We'll do this to the end of the row. We'll skip each of the chain three double crochet spaces. I'm at the end. Now I'll work in a double crochet in the last stitch. Great. It's a piece. So this is what it looks like at the end of this row. So we've been able to our stitch count now. We have 57 shells. And we also have 2 double crochets. You know, the chain at the beginning of the round counts as a stitch. So great. This is the part that gets interesting. We just go back to repeating the whole set of the pattern again, what we've been doing since the beginning of the row of the pattern. So you turn, and we have chain 3 at the beginning of our chain 4 at the beginning, and this chain 4 counts as double crochet and chain 1. When we work in the next stitch, we'll refer to the chain 1 space. So you work double crochet into the next stitch, and then you chain 1, you skip the next 3 stitches, 1, 2, 3, and you work in double crochet into the next, chain 2, double crochet into the next stitch. So this is what we'll do throughout this row. Chain 1, skip next 3 stitches, double crochet into the next stitch, chain 2, and then we'll do that. This sequence, that's what you are following. You will be repeating this chain 1, skip next 3 stitches, double crochet into the next, chain 2, double crochet into the next stitch, chain 1, skip next 3 stitches, double crochet into the next stitch, chain 2, double crochet into the next. This is what it looks like. Can you see that? So I'll repeat this to the end of this row. So this is what it looks like. I'm at the end of the row. We'll now chain one, skip next three stitches, and to keep our edge smooth, don't forget that we are not done. You chain one and you double crochet in the next stitch. So that is it. Great. So we move to row four and we chain three now. We turn. Sorry for that. Row four now, we've chained three. We walk in two double crochet into the same stitch. That gives us three double crochet in that stitch. It will become relevant in subsequent rows. So we walk in shell in our chain two spaces. So can you guess what the chain two space is? This is our chain two space. We skip chain one, skip chain one. Each of the stitches that look like V, that's where we're working our shell into. So we work in five double crochet, which is our shell, in the chain two space. Five double crochets into each of the chain two spaces. Skip chain one. So with each of the rows in the video, I just keep quiet about the chain one space and walk only into the chain two spaces. So this is what will continue throughout this row and makes it super easy and faster for us to grasp just the chain two spaces. This is what it looks like. You continue like that, such that it gives a staggered look for the shells. Can you see that they are really not on a straight line? Can you see how it goes? They are really not on a straight line, the shells. That's the five. This is the chain one space. Chain one space. You skip all the chain one spaces. You walk only into the chain two spaces, which is what we are doing here. Can you see that? We walk into only this chain two space, five double crochet in each of the chain two spaces. Chain two spaces, chain two spaces. I'll continue my sequence, and once I'm back, once I get to the end of this round, which will take me a while, I'll be back to show you what it looks like. Five, make sure that you have five double crochets. If you don't have up to five, it will be challenging when you start skipping three stitches in the next row. If you have more than five double crochets, when you to skip three stitches, you might get confused, and it will make your shells not to look, and your finished work not to look beautiful. So the pain for this part of the square is to make sure that you have five double crochets in chain two spaces, and that you're working only into chain two spaces. You skip chain one space and work only into chain two spaces. Makes it beautiful, right? So I'm at the end of the row, and if you remember when two rows below, I was talking about we have been chained for at seven as our double crochet and chain one space. I was referring to it that it will make sense when we get to the next row. So this is that now. So the chain four counted as a double crochet and chain one space, and we double crochet into the next stitch. So now we'll be working in three double crochet into the chain one space at the end of the row. So the beginning and ending of the row really matters to give a smooth and straight transition into this part. So we will not end this way. After we've worked in double crochet, three double crochets into the chain one space. Okay, yeah, sorry for the confusion. We work in these three double crochet into this chain, and then that's the end of our row. We'll chain 4 and then we turn. Great. So we'll turn and then we can continue the next row, which is row 5. We'll skip this count as a stitch, remember? So we're not going to walk into this opening because we're counting it as our first stitch. So we skip this next stitch and we walk in double crochet into the next stitch. And as I always say, if you get confused or you are the type that always love to count your to ignore your turning chain, you are still welcome to do similar thing with this. You can walk in a double crochet into that, but remember that you're not following the pattern so that you won't get confused. Remember that when you get to the turn, you don't count it as two stitches. So to avoid confusion, most of the time I just count my turning chain as a stitch. So this round is the same as the previous round that we worked. We're only making the chain two, chain one spaces. So we chain one now, skip next three stitches, and we'll work in double crochet into this. Chain two, double crochet into the next stitch. This is what we'll repeat till the end of the row. We'll chain one, skip next three stitches, and we'll work in a double crochet. Chain two, double crochet into the next stitch. Chain one, skip next three stitches and work in double crochet, chain two, and then you work in a double crochet. So I've chained one, you work in your double crochet into that. So basically this is what we'll repeat. This is row 5, and then once I'm done at this, the end of row 5, I'll repeat my row 2, row 3, row 4, row 5. You come back again, row 2, row 3, row 4, row 5. That's what you continue to repeat till you get to row 26. And that will show us the end of the round. And as I've stated, when you get to the end, if you're for king size, you chain 56 again at the beginning, walking double crochet as we did a few minutes ago. So this is what you continue to do till you have the desired length and dimension for the size of your blanket or a pillow or a cushion cover, whatever you call it. So thank you so much for sticking by me. I'd like to see what you've come up with. Kindly subscribe to my channel and also come to my Facebook group. Show me what you've been up to. If you have any questions, if this is not clear, please kindly let me know and I'll be sure to answer and improve to serve you better. Thank you.